Hey there, Kisma here, your prosperity code mentor, and I've been doing some deep dive studies over the past few days, really preparing for something exciting coming out, so keep your eyes and ears open for that. We'll be announcing it next week. Yet there was a question I asked a lot of my students, my clients, definitely in the ashram group, and possibly to you at some point. And this was back when the coronavirus started happening and we were looking at a massive lockdown of the country and faced with a lot of fear of health and wealth. And now on top of that, we've been met with really facing the racism in our country and all the ways that it is preventing, especially we're focused on Black lives and Black voices. And I know this is going into other ethnic groups. I mean, I can speak openly about my daughter who's half Asian and she's taking this very seriously for herself. And so many people, I mean, basically we are our country here in the United States of America and in the world in terms of coronavirus has been brought to its knees. So when something like this happens, when we're really brought to our knees, when we have to look at who we are, the core of our soul, our heart, our thoughts, you know, the racism conversation really makes us look and examine our thoughts every single day, our attitudes. And when we look at coronavirus and the impact it has had on financials for many people, we have to again look at our heart and our soul and our thoughts. So full circle to what I was sharing at the front of this video is this. I heard on the beautiful Marie Kondo, she does these shows on folding and packing and tidying up, and she was holding a pair of pants. And she said to the owner, you know, think about what you want to take into the future. And she was talking about clothes. And I remember Nick and I were watching the show together because we were at the beginning of coronavirus. We're like, this is a great time to declutter. And I'll share how that paid off. And we looked at each other and was like, whoa, this is not just about physical. In fact, yeah, use it for physical. What do you want to take with you into the future? Is it this book? Is it that book? Is it these pants? Whatever that, you know, what brings you a spark of joy? Easy. When I presented this question probably 2 months ago, it was, what is the attitude that you want to take with you into the future? What are the feelings? What are the beliefs? What is it about you that you want to take in the future? And what is it about you that you want to freaking leave behind? And we have to continue, I believe. I mean, I can't tell you what to do, but I can ask you to consider, because I know this is something that I go back into deeply and think about, what is it that I want to take into the future about myself and my beliefs and my heart, about my prosperity and wealth, health, love, and spirituality? What am I ready to leave behind? Part of leaving behind is, for me, like, just not caring what people think or what they say about me or my teachings. I can't put energy on someone who's going to criticize me. I can't put energy on a past client who is going to make up stories about me. It's not going to serve my mission or the people that are right in front of me who want to move forward. It's certainly not going to help me master what I'm teaching, which is why I teach what I teach. I want to master it at the highest level. I want to put any hint of judgment of other people, of criticism behind me. You know, there are some really great spiritual teachers that have said to us, criticism will really rip out your own joy. We have to remember the boomerang, right? The cause and effect, the karma. If we're putting criticism and judgment out there to someone, it's going to come back. Do we discern? Yes. Do we assess? Yes. Do we make decisions and in some ways judgments based on our intellect? Yes. We have to know who who we're going to take with us into the future, this question is also part of your people. Who is in your life that you're like, these are the people that stay with me as I move forward? Who is in your life that is not thinking the way that you think or is not believing the way that you believe? And you know, if you stay in their realm, you're not going to have an opportunity to rise to your highest and best. So everything is about getting super clear in you, not what someone is telling you to think, not what your family says you should be, or not what your friends say you should have. Really get clear in your heart what you're going to take into the future in terms of, yes, you could think about what is the home that you want to take in the future, what is the family unit, what are the pets you want to have or take into the future, but more importantly, internally. What's your belief? What's in your heart? What is your soul? Because I can tell you very, very clearly that whenever I go against my soul, it is like someone is squeezing me and putting so much pressure until I release and I'm like, okay, let's go. So sometimes it's just your willingness to listen to your higher self and your soul and take action and not care what other people are going to say or do, or if you're going to do it wrong. Because we will mess up, we'll make mistakes. Yet that's how we also can learn, right? These are not purposeful mistakes. These are like, could have done that better, could have said this differently, could have showed up. All right, got it. My teacher in India always says the past is for learning. It's not to dwell on. So this whole conversation of what we're taking into the future is really about, okay, past, sliding on over. I learned from the past. What am I creating right now, right here with my heart, in alignment with my mind and my soul, and taking it into the future? I guarantee if you have this conversation every single day with yourself, whatever you truly desire and want to create, you will attract and you will receive, because you're constantly realigning. What am I going to take into the future? So think about, you know, a simple exercise of daily. What am I going to take into this day forward that will serve myself, serve my family, my loved ones, whatever your personal universe is? What are you going to take forward? It's such a powerful reset, and one that becomes very exciting, because I'm giving you permission, if you need it, that you get to choose. More importantly, give yourself permission to choose who you want to be, what your beliefs are, what's your heart, what you want to take into the future, and what you want to create. It's exciting to live that way. And you know, you've heard me say it, maybe, maybe not, but I know my clients and students have heard me say, you know, life is a whisper. It's a whisper. We don't know how long we have. So let's make every day, as Marie Kondo would say, a spark of joy. I like to say a spark of soul. So type in below, you know, share, what is it? Like, what are those things about you, your beliefs, your character, your choices, your actions that you are going to take into the future? And make note. And it's okay if you change it. Just kind of check in every day with yourself. Definitely, it can be a weekly or a monthly exercise to examine, okay, did I take that? You know, make a list. Did I take that forward this month? Did I leave it behind? How did it work for me? All right, so if you're in, put a Y in the comments, post below a few of your thoughts, and let's create a really beautiful life together, because this is what the universe wants. This is what God, Spirit, Source wants. We have to remember that. It wants for us more than we possibly could imagine. So let's get in alignment with it all. All right, everyone, much love, and see you soon. Namaste.